start me at 100. 100 for a start, they want. 100 I bid. 100 I bid. Who give me 10? Who make it 110? I'm looking for 110. 110. 110 I bid. 110. Who make it 20? Who make it 20? Come on, gentlemen. Who make it 20? 120 I bid. It's with you, madam, at 120. Do I hear 50? 150 anywhere? Come on, gentlemen. That's a genuine antique. They don't come up every day. 150. 150 I bid. $3.50 anywhere. Don't lose it, madam. Don't lose it for another 50. $3.50 anywhere. $3.50 I'm bid. At $3.50. Who'll make it four? I'm looking for four. Any more? At $3.50. Are you all done? At $3.50. At $3.50. Lovejoy.
Hello, Lovejoy. Fancy the jelly glass, do you?
A destructive of the most interesting, most beautiful, oldest buildings in the village.
Lovejoy.
Please, Woody.
A cup of Earl Grey, perhaps.
You know what that is, don't you, Mr. Lovejoy?
I can see it's not a singing telegram.
£10,000? You people are banana short of a bunch of something. I haven't got that kind of money.
Mr. Lovejoy, the Inland Revenue has not had a penny out of you for the past 3 years. Well, that's only just over 3,000 a year.
Oh, only 3,000 a year, is that all? Well, you had me worried for a minute.
How do you propose to pay it?
Pay it? Can't pay it. Well, I mean, that is not all in one go.
You could go to prison, you know.
Look, I'm sure there's a benevolent streak somewhere in an attractive woman like you. Hmm? Would you consider giving me time to pay?
How much had you in mind?
About a decade.
How about a month?
How about six?
Make it two and you've got a deal.
You don't have a pearl-handled revolver in there somewhere, do you?
Oh, I'm sure you manage, Mr. Lovejoy. You strike me as being one of life's natural survivors.
Do I?
We'll be monitoring your progress, Mr. Lovejoy.
Oh, I'll bet you will. You got any rat poison, Woody?
I've put it in already.
Hello, Lovejoy.
One of the joys of buying rare and beautiful things is coming to a sale like this. Now, most of the punters here are farmers who are here to bid each other sky high over a roll of tangled chicken wire, a dozen ball ties and an old Cortina. Oh, non-runner, of course. What they don't know is that beneath this pile of crap is something so valuable that if they bought it, they wouldn't have to look at a cow's udder for 12 months. But they won't buy it because they neither have the knowledge nor the skill. But I have, and I will. What are you doing?
Oh, hello, Lovejoy. I didn't think you were going to make it.
Well, why did you drag me down here? I mean, this really is a load of crap.
Ah, oh, you're wrong there, Lovejoy. As President Reagan would say, you ain't seen nothing yet.
Well, where is it?
All in good time, Lovejoy. All in good time.
So who was this Catesby then?
Oh, it was a local scrap merchant and a terrible farmer. This whole place go to ruin when his son went inside.
What did he go inside for?
I don't know. I think he got 4 years for grievous bodily harm and burglary, something like that. What about that, then?
What about it?
18th century, all oak, Welsh dresser.
Half missing?
No, it's not. I gathered up all the pieces this morning with my own bare hands.
What about all this chicken shit? It burns the woodges.
Not this, though. That's 300 years old if it's a day. It's as hard as bell metal, is that?
Any worm?
Oh, nothing that a cup full of polyfiller and a gob of beeswax wouldn't cure. I saw one of these knocked down last month for 1,500 quid, and that was to the trade.
And what's Gimbert's estimate?
He'd be happy with five.
Any competition?
Oh, just a bunch of scrap merchants and pig farmers who couldn't tell a Welsh dresser from Welsh rabbit. Hey, there is a Frenchman, though. Vol or...
Vial?
Vial, ready money merchant, wholesaler. Reckons he divides his time between London and Dijon.
Surprises no watermark.
No, but he wants to view this, though.
What are you doing?
I told him it was buried under a bale of hay, and I'd root it out for him. I mentioned it was good for nothing but firewood, but he said he'd probably bid for it anyway, sight unseen.
Well, it might not be a bad idea just to show him it anyway.
That's not fair, Lovejoy. You're going to get us into trouble.
I stopped being fair the day I started selling this stuff. Lay that down and cover it over with stuff, eh?
Be a little something in this for you, Tinker? It usually is a little something.